All right, well, we have some breaking news just in. The Prime Minister moments ago touching down in Berlin ahead of NATO talks, announcing one of the biggest defence deals in Australia's history is being inked. Anthony Albanese today inking a deal to export over 100 locally made heavy weapon carriers to Germany starting 2025.
This will be one of our largest ever exports. We'll guarantee that the 1,000 jobs that are there in Queensland will go into the future and will be worth in excess of $1 billion for the Australian economy. This will boost our sovereignty, this will increase our defence capability and boost our economy. This is a great outcome, and it's the first outcome of quite a few that we have ready to announce tomorrow with our friends here in Germany.
The military vehicles will be produced at Redbank in Queensland, securing around 1,000 jobs. All right, let's go live now to Europe correspondent Brett McLeod, who's in London for us. Brett, Joe Biden also NATO-bound, where Ukraine will be top of the agenda.
Certainly will be. He'll be arriving in London in a few hours' time for talks with Rishi Sunak. But one of the most controversial aspects of this war is going to be front and centre. That's the United States agreeing to supply Ukraine with cluster munitions. These are ones which spread over a large area and are meant to explode on contact with the ground, but a percentage don't. So that's why Australia, the United Kingdom and more than 100 other countries have signed an agreement never to allow cluster munitions to be used. But America is going to supply them to Ukraine. So that's clearly going to come up. He and Mr. Sunak will meet at Downing Street before Mr. Biden goes on to meet the King. Of course, when they meet in Lithuania for the NATO summit, the issue will come up whether Ukraine is ready to join NATO. Mr. Biden says not yet.
I don't think it's ready for membership in NATO. So holding NATO together is really critical. I don't think there is unanimity in NATO about whether or not to bring Ukraine into the NATO family now, at this moment, in the middle of a war.
Quite a lot for NATO allies and Australia to talk about over the next few days, Sarah.
Thank you, Brett.